Good morning, my dear students. This is part 5 for MCET. In this video, we discuss 2019 previous MCET questions. These questions are taken from 3rd May 2019 second shift questions. Few questions we discuss here. Within short span of time, you can easily decide the answer by mind calculation. Some questions are, it takes one or two steps. Some questions are more steps. Don't bother about that. Such type of questions are very few in MCET. But totally we are focused on that type of questions. That's why we are getting less marks. Don't waste the time. Actually, in MCET exam, no negative marking. Keep in your mind that everyone apply, everyone attend mains and advanced, all these tests have appeared. So your mindset is negative marking to that question. But here MCET, no negative marking. So you can answer all the questions. Don't fear. So whichever you know very well, first of all, out of 160 questions, you select that questions, you have to answer that questions, damn sure questions, you get the marks in that. For example, in 160 questions, you know 50. Okay, 50 damn sure, definitely you got 50 marks. Remaining 130, 50 questions, choices are there. These two options are wrong, maybe either this or this, two options. So you select any one and mark that one, that 50. Automatically you get 25 marks in 50, in those 50 questions. So 50 plus 25, 75, remaining 80 questions. Remaining 60 questions, you answered anyone. So definitely there you got 15, 75 plus 15, 90 questions. Surely you get a good seat in very familiar engineering colleges. Sometimes it happens JNTU also. Okay, now come to here. The set of all the solutions of the inequation 3 power x plus 3 power 1 minus x minus 4 less than 0. 3 power x plus 3 power 1 minus x minus 4 less than 0. Let us check that. 1, look here, first, 3rd, 4th, do not contain 1. Let us check that 1 satisfy or not. If you substitute x equal to 1, 3 plus 3 power 0, 3 power 0 is 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 minus 4, 0, 0 less than 0, that is wrong. So, x equal to 1 is wrong. X equal to 1 not satisfy. If the interval contains 1, that is wrong. So, it is wrong answer. Now, check that. 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 1 to 3. So, let us take an element between 0 and 1. For example, 1 by 2, x equal to 1 by 2, substitute here, x equal to 1 by 2, root 3, plus 1 minus 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2, root 3 plus root 3, 2 root 3, that is root 12. Root 12 is less than 4, root 12 minus 4 less than 0, that is true, x equal to 1 by 2 is one of the solution of that equation, that inequality. So, 1 by 2 contains this. So, it may be right answer. 1 by 2 is not in this. 1 by 2 is not in this. So, that's why 3, 4 wrong. This is the right answer. Now, how to solve this question? It also takes 2 minutes. Don't bother about that. Let us take 3 power x taken as some p plus 3 by p less than 4. Cross multiplication. Take this side. P square minus 4p plus 3 less than 0, which implies p belongs to 1, 2, 3. P means 3 power x. 3 power x equal to p, that belongs to. So, x belongs to, this is nothing but 3 power 0 to 3 power 1. So, x belongs to 0 to 1. This type of solution also necessary and develop your concepts. Okay. X belongs to 0 to 1. That's why that is the right answer. Now here, the number of values of n belongs to n for which n plus 2 c2 is 2, n plus 1. That means n plus 2 into n plus 1 by, look here, this value is n plus 3, n plus 3 c1, so that is n plus 3 equal to 4 is to 2, that means 2. By cross multiplication and write in order, n square plus 3n plus 2 equal to 2n plus 6. That means n square plus n minus 4 equal to 0. There is no factors. No factors. Let us take, let us observe that delta b square minus 4ac, b square is 1, 4ac, that is plus 16, 1 plus 16, root 17, it is not a perfect square. So, no roots. That means no integral roots, no natural roots. That's why number of roots are 0. Now, we are going to the next question. It belongs to the binomial rational rational index. If for mod x less than 4 by 3, the approximate value of 1 by 4 minus 3x whole power 1 by 2. Taking common 4 from this, as well as take up 4 minus 3x whole power minus 1 by 2, 4 taking common, 4 power minus 1 by 2, that become 1 by 2 into 1 minus 3x whole power minus 1 by 2. 1 minus 3x whole power, 1 plus x whole power n, 1 plus x whole power px, power multiply with base, that's enough. We get two terms, 1 by 2 into 1, look carefully, minus 1 by 2, this multiply, plus 3x by 2. Next, terms are there, the next immediate term, you can write first one as it is, and next, whatever it may be the term, you have to multiply the power, we get the second term. Whatever it may be the power, and whatever it may be the term, along with the sign, you have to multiply that, the minus minus plus, 3x into 1 by 2, 3x by 2. You check that. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 3x by, look here, 3x by 4 actually. 3x by, whenever taking common 4, that become here 3x by 4. Don't forget this. So, that become here 3x by 8. 3x by 8. Actually here by 4, you are taking common 4. 1 by 2 increase. Multiply that to 3x by 8. After this multiply, 3x by 16. 3x by 16. And so on. Now, observe. Which option contains these two terms? 1 by 2 plus 3x by 16. Third option. First option, 1 by 4 minus wrong. Second wrong. Third, maybe fourth wrong. So, third option is the right answer. These three are wrong. Now, next question, that is a plus b plus c equal to 270, then a plus b plus c equal to 270, then sigma cos 2a plus 4 pi sin a. Whenever a b 90, b 90, c 90, automatically sum is 270. Go to the verification, a 90, b 90, c 90. Sigma cos 2a, that means cos 180. Cos 180 is minus 1. Sigma 1. Next, plus 4. Pi. Pi stands product. Sigma stands summation. Sin 90. Sin 90 is 1. That equal to sigma 1 is minus 3. Plus 4. Pi 1. Pi 1 means 1 into 1 into 1. 1 only, so 4 into 4, so that value is 1, look here, 1, so I thought of the right answer. Next, once again, sigma, if you expand this, actually sigma cos 2a is cos 2a plus cos 2b plus cos 2c, pi sin a, that means sin a, sin b, sin c, that that value. Pi indicates product and sigma indicates summation. Actually, the question is given like that, but I noted as in a simple manner. Now, the general solution of the equation, cos 2x minus 2 tan x plus 2 equal to 0. Here tan x is there, cos 2x, we can easily decide the answer. Very simple. Look here, pi by 3, pi by 3, pi by 3, pi by 3. If you take n equal to 0, pi by 3, pi by 3, pi by 3. If this satisfies pi by 3, answer is in 1, 2, 3, any one of these. If satisfy n equal to pi by 4, if you satisfy x equal to pi by 4, fourth of the right answer, we need not check the first, second, third. So, by mind calculation, we can easily decide the answer. Now, let us check x equal to pi by 4. Cos pi by 2x, 2 into pi by 4, pi by 2, cos 90, 0. Tan pi by 4, x is pi by 4, tan pi by 4, 1, minus 2, plus 2. This is 0. So, that satisfies, that equal to 0, that satisfies. So, fourth option is the right answer. So, within short span of time, we can easily decide the answer. But, we solve the question that we also learn. Cos 2x, 1 minus tan square x by 1 plus tan square x. Tan x taken as t, 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square minus 2t plus 2 equal to 0. Taking common, minus 2 or 2, 1 minus t. So 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square minus plus 2 into 1 minus t equal to 0. Overall, taking common 1 minus t. That means 1 minus t is one of the factor of that. So 1 minus t equal to 0 implies t equal to 1, t equal to 1, t stands tan x equal to 1, x equal to pi by 4, that is the principal angle. General solution is x equal to n pi plus pi by 4. Okay, that's right, that is the right answer. Another factor is there, we don't bother about that, don't spend time to that equation. We get the answer, why unnecessarily go to that? Okay, my dear students, you have to focus that particular question only. Don't deviate, don't go to the unnecessary equations. Okay, thank you.